And we get up and get ready to go on the tap controlled by the Cavaliers. Braden McNary comes up with a loose ball. And Sisseton will match up man-on-man. McNary, right of the key, keeps the dribble alive. Will bring it into the paint. Now dumps it off to Hayline. Down low block, right side is Hemrick. He'll kick it corner to Holmstrom. Now back to Hemrick. Around the horn it comes. Sisseton working around. And the clock has not started. Clock has not started up on the board. And... well, at 7:25 to go, Roncalli inbounding from the Sisseton side. Pass will go left wing to Sam Reinen. Reinen brings it out top to Landon Hayline. Now on the wing for Holmstrom to McNary. Comes off a high pick. He'll take it in. Triple teamed. Kicks it off right side. Now Holmstrom, a good look for three and knocks it down good. Roncalli really took their time that opening series and work it around. And Holmstrom gets a great look for three and knocks it down right of the key. 3-0. Full court pressure here by the Redmen. Cranhold will get the ball to Hunter Maidenwald. And they'll play catch still about at the free throw line. Now the pass up the floor goes to Nathan Nigg. He'll let traffic clear. Now gives the ball back to Cranhold. Cranhold leaves it off to Maidenwald, top of the key. Pass right side, knocked away by Holmstrom and picked off by Hemrick. They'll get it back to Holmstrom, who drives, dishes right side. Reinen thought about it. Now Hayline posting middle of the lane. Instead, they'll go to McNary. Right side three is up and off the back iron. No good. Rebound, though. Reinen will take it to the basket on a runner. Can't get it. Follow shot up and short. No good, but Reinen's a couple looks each time down, and Reinen's free throw. Sam Reinen now gets ball back. Second free throw up and in, and it's a 5-0 Cavalier lead. Roncalli again will stick in the full court pressure. Maidenwald in the backcourt along with Fitz trying to wear the pressure down. Pass will come left side. Nigg still shy of the timeline. Reads double team, and there's a 10-second count, and the Cavalier pressure. Inbounds pass comes to Holmstrom. He'll give it right side to Hayline. Free throw line extended. Now top of the key, McNary. They'll work at left side for Holmstrom on the perimeter. Coming off a high pick is Reinen, and there's a foul called on Cranhold grabbing on in play. Sisseton staying man-on-man defensively. And boy, flash out to the high post to the free throw line. Hemrick gets the pass. Look away feed to McNary, who cuts in left side and lays it in uncontested. 7-0. Roncalli jumps out to the early lead. In the backcourt, Fitz and Cranhold trying to break down the pressure. Now they'll get it across the line to Fitz. 3-on-2, bounce underneath. And the shot is up and no good for Sisseton. Underneath there was Math 2 minutes in. Free throw shot is up and bounces and falls in good. So the Redmen have yet to take a field goal attempt, but get their first point of the game from the foul line. And one more to go for Nealand, as he will put it up and off the side, no good. Rebound tapped around, and Hemrick comes away with it and will give it off to Braden McNary. There's a feed. McNary tries to thread the needle and throws it away. Ball picked up by Nealand. Back the other way, and a blocking foul is going to be called on Hayline and Landon Hayline. And the Cavaliers now will match up defensively in his own defense. Underneath, Dominic White will get the inbound pass. The shot is up and good. Count it. Redmen back within three, and the shot is up and good. So Sisseton's rattled off four straight, and it's a 7-4 Roncalli lead. 5:35 to play first quarter. Everson across the timeline with the pass will get it to Holmstrom. He'll penetrate the lane, now dumps it to Everson left baseline. Everson out top. Reinen will let fly from three. That one might have been partially blocked, and the rebound is grabbed inside by Fitz. Fitz will give it off to Cranhold, and now the Redmen back the other way. Cranhold goes left side, trying to drive his Hunter Maidenwald. He'll kick it back off to Cranhold. Now White wide open left block, and he's going to get it up, and a travel will be called on White as he turns to the back. Roncalli too, but the travel occurred before anything happened. So Roncalli now back the other way. Everson will give the ball right side to McNary. He'll drive to the free throw line from the wing. Now backs it off on the wing. Holmstrom from three. Rims in and out. No good. Rebound is batted around. Hemrick will tap it out front, and Reinen will get the ball. Will give it off to McNary. He'll drive. His shot is up and blocked, but Hemrick saves it. Cavaliers now will work it down low to Everson. His shot in the lane. No good. And Hemrick ends up on the deck, and a battle for the ball. They're going to call a jump. No, and trying to negate the Cavaliers did so with that aggressive man-on-man defense. Again, full court pressure now. Sisseton will break it. White across the timeline with the pass. Holds it on the wing and will give it off to Maidenwald out front. Now left side, Fitz thought about a three. Will back it out top to Hunter Maidenwald, who will dribble to the top of the key. Pass left, knocked away by Holmstrom. Ball loose, and Maidenwald will get it back. Goes to Fitz. Now to Dominic White. Low left block, too far underneath. He'll try to work it out on the wing. Ball tapped free, but getting it is Maidenwald. His shot from the free throw line is up and no good. And he'll Hemrick pulls down the rebound, outlets to Reinen, who lays it up and in. Boy, that's a nice fast break for Roncalli to get the long passes down the floor, and an easy two layup for Sam Reinen. 9-4 Cavs, 4 minutes to play for first quarter. Dominic White gets the pass across the timeline, and again, we'll hold it up for Ethan Cranhold. Roncalli extends the zone out to beyond the three-point line. Maidenwald will go left. The ball knocked away by Holmstrom out of bounds. And Sisseton will kick to Cranhold between the circles. He'll give it right side to Fitz. Now the pass out top to Maidenwald. Left side, Cranhold from the corner three. Shot up and no good. And Hemrick up with the rebound. Will pull it down. Gives it to Everson. Pass goes left side to Reedy on the perimeter. Reedy and McNary play catch. Good look for three from Reedy. And that one's off the back iron. No good. Rebound pulled down by Cranhold, who will bring it back the other way with the dribble. Cranhold brings it all the way to the right baseline. Now we'll kick it out top, taking it to the rack. Shot up and no good by Matt Nealand, but the follow by Dunn back in the game, as is Dustin Mosier for Sisseton. First free throw for Dominic White, up and good. White now with the ball back in possession for the second of two foul shots. It is on the way, up and good, and that'll pull Sisseton within three at 9-6. 3:10 to play, first quarter. Everson up the middle of the floor. Will set the offense for Roncalli. Gets it to Reedy underneath. He'll get the shot up and good from the baseline from about 5 feet out. Reedy tried to get a fake and get his guy in the air. Didn't get it, but finished strong enough to get it to crawl in good. Now here is Sisseton at the other end. White will turn to the basket, will drive. Nice spin move in the lane. Puts up a tough shot and kind of off balance a little. 8 foot runner off the glass is good. Dominic White keeping Sisseton in it here early. McNary with the basketball brings it foul line. Now we'll give it right side to Reedy. Reedy gets a screen, leaves it off top of the key to Everson. Everson will dribble left, keeps it alive, and will go to Reedy now right of the key into the corner. Schaefauer squares from three. That one off the back iron, no good. Rebound pulled down by Ethan Cranhold, and Sisseton back the other way. Cranhold brings it to the wing, will kick it out top of the key for Maidenwald. Now around the horn it comes left side into the corner for Mosier. Back it comes to Cranhold. Right side three from the corner. Up and long, no good, but the rebound backside by Sisseton, and a foul is going to be called on Schaefauer trying to get after the basketball. Schaefauer still 2:07 to play first quarter. In left bounce pass from underneath will come out top to Andrew Fitz. Fitz will give it left to Cranhold, who dribbles along the arc. Now gives it right side. Fitz from the three-point line looks from the wing. Nothing there. Goes top of the key to Maidenwald. Left side, Cranhold. Nice baseline drive. Will take it in. Shot is up, no good, and Schaefauer did a great job to draw that charge with defensively to draw that charge. Sisseton now back to defense at midcourt, showing man-on-man inside the three-point line. Schaefauer top of the key, left side to Everson. Now top of the key, McNary will drive, leaves it back. Schaefauer looks at the three. Now we'll give it off to Reedy left wing. Good defense here by Sisseton to get out and contest the wing. Here is a nice pass from McNary underneath to Reinen, who puts it up and in. A drive by McNary, and then he dumps it off last minute to Reinen, who puts it up and good. He's got six first quarter points. 13-8, Cavs by five. Dominic White left wing with it for Sisseton with 1:20 to play in the quarter. Redmond get it right wing for Cranhold. He'll launch a three from out front. Rims in and out. No good. And the rebound taken by Everson. Everson up the right side will give it to Reedy on the perimeter. Now McNary will come back between the circles. Gets it underneath. Nice feed to Reinen on the right block. Too far under. He'll lob it off on the wing for Schaefauer. Long cross court pass to Reedy. Now to Reinen on the right corner. Reinen will take it baseline. Goes in strong and is going to be hammered as he goes in. Sam Reinen backs here tonight. First of two free throws on the way is up and good. Hemrick and Holmstrom back for Roncalli. A second foul shot. It's up and good. 15-8 Cavaliers with 56 seconds to play first quarter. Full court pressure shown here by Roncalli. In the backcourt, Maidenwald will get it left side to Nealand. Now a long pass across the timeline will go off to Nealand. He'll leave it back to Maidenwald. Now on the right wing, Nealand will get a free throw line, dumps it left side to Mosier. Mosier top of the key, goes to Andrew Fitz. He'll dribble, thinks about the three, now foot on the three-point line, puts it up from 17, shot in and out, no good. Rebound pulled down by Schaefauer. They'll give it to Holmstrom. Shot clock is basically off. The game clock is a second ahead of the shot clock here, so the Cavaliers are going to hold for the final shot here with Holmstrom dribbling out near the center circle. Holmstrom will give it left for Schaefauer. Clock down to 15 seconds to play in the quarter. Roncalli a 7-point lead and hoping to get something more here before the quarter break. With 10 seconds now, Holmstrom will back it up to the center circle. He'll get a screen from Reedy. Holmstrom gives it right. Now dumps it into the corner as Schaefauer will launch from three. Shot no good. And the time will run out. That is education. 15-8. The Cavaliers lead Sisseton after a quarter. We'll get you numbers in a moment. Roncalli with the basketball. Holmstrom will lob it up high for Reinen. The ball knocked free from him, but Zach Hemrick will get the rebound back. Will go up strong. Shot no good. Gets the rebound back and a jump ball. No, they put it in play. McNary just right of the basket will lob it out front for Holmstrom. Again, Sisseton sticking man on man, but really playing it hard. Now here's a nice feed underneath to Hemrick. Shot up no good, but Dominic White will pick up the foul. Hemrick to the foul line looking for his first points tonight, and his free throw up and good. Roncalli was 5 of 14 for 37%. They go 4 of 4 from the free throw line. As he gets the ball back, shot on the way is good, and it's a 9-point Cavalier lead, their biggest of the night, 20 seconds into this second quarter. Ethan Kranhold will pick up his dribble. Now we'll go to Nathan Nigg. Nigg and Kranhold again trying to break this pressure down. Kranhold still shy of the timeline. Gets it across in time. Dominic White, right of the free throw line, will back it off now to Maidenwald out front. Right side to Kranhold. He'll take it in and has a lane to the basket and lays it up good. Ethan Kranhold's first basket of the night. Found a lane and attacks the rim. 17-10 Cavs. Left side Hayline back in the game. Dribbles along the arc. Now we'll lob it up for Hemrick underneath. He'll go up strong from underneath and put it up and in. Hemrick finishes with two bodies on him, but Zach's first field goal of the game, and he's got 4 points quickly here in the second quarter. Here's a long pass up the floor, and 2-on-1. Sisseton doesn't take advantage. They back it off now to Maidenwald, right wing, around the horn, left side to Nathan Nigg on the perimeter. Nigg beyond the three-point line. Dribbles along the arc, gives it top of the key to White. Now right side to Maidenwald. Now they hand it off. Kranhold will drive left, kicks it. Nigg will drive in and dump it back off. Kranhold wanted a three look, didn't get it. Now out top, White from 17 will launch with a shot clock running down, and he'll put it up and in. Dominic White hasn't missed tonight. 9 of Sisseton's 12 points. 19-12 Cavs. Minute and a half gone, second quarter. McNary at the foul line. Nice spin move in the lane, but the shot rejected by Matthew Nieland. He'll get it the length of the floor, takes it to the hole, and lays it up and in. That's a great play by Sisseton's Matthew Nieland to swat it away from McNary and then turn it into 2 at the other end. Redmond closed the gap to 5 with 6:05 to play first half. Right side is Holmstrom. He'll dump it off to Hayline. In traffic, goes up strong but out of control. Put it off the glass too hard. Rebound by White, and now the Redmen a chance to cut it back to a 3-point ball game. Ethan Kranhold across the line. Brings it foul line. Now we'll give it off to White. Free throw line extended. Around the horn it comes. Sisseton will go left side to Kranhold into the high post. Nieland with it will go strong to the basket. Gets a little runner and puts it up and in. Redmond 4 of 4 from the floor to start the second quarter and have outscored the Cavaliers 8-4. Roncalli taking that timeout with possession. The ball will come left side to McNary. Now middle of the lane is Hemrick with it. He'll back it off out front. Pass for Hayline off his fingertips. He'll run it down at the center circle, and Hayline now will have to throw it up and will get it over to Reinen over on the far side of the floor. Reinen will leave it off to McNary with 15 on the shot clock. Pass will come right side to Holmstrom. Underneath on the block is Hemrick, and high off the glass. His shot is up and in. Well, the Cavs leaning on Zach Hemrick here second quarter. He's got all 6 points in this period for Roncalli. Kranhold reading the pressure. Now we'll get it across the timeline to Nigg. Nigg will hold it up on the wing, and now we'll leave it back off to Kranhold out front. Cavs back in that slider zone. Driving is Nigg in traffic. Shot up no good, but White comes through, takes the ball away, and will draw a foul as he goes. 9 points here in this first half. Make it 10 as his shot is up and good. Jaden Everson back for the Cavs as Hayline will sit. Second foul shot here is up and off the mark. No good. I jinxed him. Reinen pulls down the rebound and will give it off to Holmstrom. Now up the floor for Everson. The ball is tipped away by McNary left of the basket. Will look inside. Now Reinen comes through and has the ball knocked away by Led throughout, but the Redmen really battling back after getting down 9 to start this second quarter. Inbounds pass will come to Reinen on the left block. He'll give it off to Everson. Now to Reinen, who goes back through. Will get it off on the perimeter. McNary from 3, up and in. Nothing but net for McNary. His first 3 of the night. 5 points for Braden McNary, and the Cavalier lead quickly to 7. Kranhold shy of the timeline. Will look left and will get it off to Nieland, or excuse Maidenwald, who brings it across, picks up the dribble, trapped, but will pass out of it. Pass will come around right side to Nig, now to Kranholt, top of the key. Kranholt gives it back to Nig on the right perimeter. Out top it comes to Nealon. Left side to Kranholt, tried to drive to the basket, nothing there, leaves it off. And now to White at the high post, right at the free throw line. White looks low, nothing there. Kranholt will flash out into the corner. Shot clock down to three. Here's Nig. He'll force up a three, and that one is off the mark, no good. Rebound grabbed by Holmstrom, and Holmstrom will lead it up the floor to Reinen. Reverse layup, tough shot up and in. That pass I thought was too far, but Reinen got there, and then a tough reverse layup going the opposite way. 26-17, Cavs back by nine. High lob pass, White pulls it down from way high, and now we'll pass it off to Nealon. Shot no good, but a foul is going to be called. A couple more here. First of two shots on the way is up and good. Gus Reedy will check in for the Cavs, and Reinen will have a second shot to come now for Nealon from the foul line. And it is on the way, up and good. So the Roncalli lead at 7 with 3:36 to play in this first half. Jaden Everson across the timeline, pressured one-on-one up front by Nealon. Pass will come left side to Reedy. He'll dribble along the perimeter. Reedy picks it up, goes middle of the lane. Hemrick with it will turn to his left side, puts a shot up over the basket. Too hard off the glass, no good. Nig the rebound, will get it off to Kranholt, who will bring it across, nearly carried it, and now a reaching foul whistled inside. It looked, but Everson called for the foul. Ethan Kranholt at the line, front end of the one-on-one is up and good. And Sisseton shooting free throws very well here. Bonus free throw for Kranholt on the way is good. Kranholt has four, all here in the second quarter. 26-21 Roncalli, 3:15 to play in the half. Everson will bring it left, now dribbles top of the key and will go right wing for Holmstrom. He'll dribble free throw line back to Everson, now to Hemrick. Hemrick will fling it right wing for Reedy, and Reedy will back it off out top for McNary. Back to Holmstrom on the wing. Holmstrom gives it off to Reedy. Inside, they'll work it, and Hemrick's going to be fouled from behind. A reaching foul called on Dominic White. That, I think, calling a timeout to talk to his kids maybe about a little adjustment. Free throw for Hemrick out of the timeout, up and and the second free throw for Zach Hemrick, up and good. He's got 8 of Roncalli's 11 points here in this second period. 28-21 Cavs. Ethan Kranholt will bring the ball the other way. Roncalli will drop back into their zone defense at midcourt. Left side is Dustin Mosier with it. He'll work it out top of the key to Matthew Nealon. Ball off his hands, but he'll run it back down. Maidenwald will bring it between the circles and gets it off left side to Mosier. Now to Nathan Nig, who brings it top of the key. Nig uses up the dribble. Now we'll get rid of it to Kranholt. Right side into the corner with 10 seconds on the shot clock. Maidenwald to Kranholt, and here's a launch from out front. Shot no good by Mosier, but followed up and good by Kranholt. That's just a heady play by Kranholt to attack the basket off the missed shot by his teammate. Back to a 5-point game. McNary will give it between the circles to Reedy with 2:10 to go. Gus Reedy picks up the dribble. Now we'll give it right side of the floor to Reinen. Reinen will put the ball down, and again, Sisseton just really working hard in the defensive set. Underneath, they'll get it to Hemrick in traffic. He grabs it and pulls it down good. Boy, Zach Hemrick's had a great second quarter, and the Cavaliers have needed him to have a big second quarter. Ethan Kranholt back the other way. Kranholt will leave it off, and we'll go left side to Nig. Into the corner, down low block is Nealon. He'll turn to the basket, up and over Hemrick. Boy, that's a tough shot by Nealon, and he gets it up and good. Sisseton shooting the ball really well in this second quarter, hanging around. 30-25 Cavs, a minute and a half to play in the first half. Holmstrom picks up the dribble. Now we'll leave it low block left side for Hemrick. He'll kick it out top of the key to McNary. McNary will drive and dish. Holmstrom thought about the three. Now we'll drive in. We'll pump it backside to Reinen. His shot up and good. Trying to draw the charge was Kranholt, but the referee didn't buy it, and Reinen lays it up and good. 32-25. Pass over the pressure. We'll get down into the left side for Mosier, and nearly stealing it was Reinen. Mosier will get it back and will fire it out front for Kranholt. Under a minute to play now in the first half. Left side, Mosier on the wing goes to Maidenwald. Now out top it comes to Nathan Nig. Back to Maidenwald beyond the three-point line on the wing. Top of the key, Kranholt dribbles down to the foul line and knocks it down good. Kranholt will pull up the 16-footer and drop it in. Kranholt had a big second quarter with 8. 32-27, Cavaliers with the ball. McNary out front will get a screen right now. We'll dump it in the corner for Holmstrom. Little pick and roll, and a runner by Holmstrom takes it to the basket, and Holmstrom will put it up and good. Cavalier lead back to 7. It's been between 5 and 9 most of the way, but Sisseton will not let it get any further, and the Redmen have been within three a couple occasions. 20 seconds now, Redmen with the basketball, kind of spread it out, look like they may be content to hold for one. Cranhold with the ball will bring it out near the timeline with 10 seconds to go. One-on-one with McNary. Now they'll come over screen. Here's Cranhold, a tough three. Shot rims around, no good. Rebound pulled down by Holmstrom. 2 seconds, one. Half-court shot on the way is up. Hits the front rim and falls away, no good. Very well-played first half. There's McNary, Holmstrom, Hamrick, Hayline, and Reinen. Sisseton with the basketball. Ethan Cranhold will bring it out between the circles and will work it left side to Nathan Nigg on the wing. Nigg will put one dribble down. Now comes to Dominic White between the circles. White will give it right side to Cranhold. Now out front, Nieland with it. Nieland goes to Maidenwald on the left wing. Maidenwald takes one dribble. Now goes to Cranhold in the corner, guarded one-on-one by McNary. Inlet pass for White. He'll turn up against Hemrick and puts the shot up. Contested well, and it comes away no good. Helmstrom came through with a little bit of help as well. Now the long pass up the floor. McNary has to reach to get it. We'll get it back. We'll put up a three and knock it down good. McNary had to scramble to run the ball down in the corner, spun to his right, and just fired the three up and knocks down nothing but net. Cavaliers now biggest lead of the game, 37-27. Nieland will give it left side to Cranhold. He'll dribble down baseline, now gives it out front for Nigg. Nigg back to Cranhold. He'll take it baseline, draws a double team, kicks it out. White, free throw line, takes a dribble into the paint. Now we'll kick it right side to Cranhold. Fall away from 17. Free throw line extended, won't go. The rebound pulled down by Holmstrom. Sisseton will hustle back defensively. The Cavs get it to McNary. Now give and go to Hayline. He'll go up strong and put it up and in. Dominic White slid over, tried to draw the charge, but Landon pulled up and puts it off the glass. Good for his first basket of the night. And Raleigh Collies come out with five quick points to start the second half. 39-27 the score. With the basketball, Cranhold. He'll float to the left with the dribble. Now gives it top of the key to White. Ball will come right side to Nigg into the corner for Maidenwald. And the pass will come out front, and it's going to go across the timeline. And Cranhold will run it down. It will be over and back. And as Sam Reinen will put the ball in play, having some trouble. Now gets it to McNary out front. McNary will dribble to the right, picks up the dribble, and now will give it off to Holmstrom, who will dribble down to the right wing, looking for Hemrick, and playing in front of him, Dominic White. Hemrick will get the ball, puts it up off the right block, shot no good, and the rebound is tapped around, loose on the deck, and Dominic White will finally pull it out of the scrum, and will pull it away, let the defense clear, and will get the ball into the hands of Maidenwald. Maidenwald across the timeline will go left for Nathan Nigg. Nigg now out front for Cranhold. Ball will come right side. Maidenwald will dribble it off. Now we'll give it to Nieland, who drives and dishes and will drag the pivot foot. He came into the lane. And we'll see if Ron Colley can take advantage. Cavs have opened up a 12-point lead here to start the second half, biggest of the night. Holmstrom will give it left side to Hayline on the wing. Now to Reinen, around the horn right side to Holmstrom. They'll try to work it out front. Instead, Reinen flashes through middle of the lane, gets a pass, and an easy look from 8 feet out in front. Sam Reinen, 14 to pace the Cavaliers tonight. Cranhold across the timeline will get rid of it now to Nigg between the circles. Ball will come back to Cranhold. He'll dribble it, gives it to Maidenwald right side. Back to Cranhold near the right corner. Now free throw line. Nieland gets the pass and throws it away. Loose ball picked off by McNary, and he's going to be run into. Nieland will stop McNary from Cavaliers, and will get it to Hemrick out front. Zach Hemrick gives it right to Hayline. Now off to Holmstrom on the perimeter. Holmstrom gives it to Braden McNary. McNary dribbling on the arc will dump it down low. Ball tapped around by Hemrick. He'll get control, get it back, and put it up and in. That's a good heady play by Hemrick to just stay calm after he tapped the ball and didn't gain control to get it back and then just take his time going up for the shot. 12 for Hemrick on the night. 43-27 Cavs. Andrew Fitz along the perimeter will get it back left wing for Cranhold. Cranhold will dribble it along the arc and will bring it all the way to the right wing. He'll stop. Gets it out top to Maidenwald. Now pass will come out front for Fitz. Fitz goes back off for Mosier. Mosier one dribble. Give and go to Maidenwald rather in the paint. Shot too hard. No good. Pass up the floor to Reinen. He'll give it off to Hayline filling the block. Shot up. No good. And then coming through McNary on the rebound will follow it up and he'll drop. Free throw for Braden McNary, up and good. McNary now with 9 in the ball game. This second half, make it 11 as McNary's free throw is up and good. 45-24. Across the timeline, Cranhold will bring it. Guarded by McNary. Down low into the block is White. His shot is up and blocked by Hemrick. And then the ball safe from going out of bounds by Reinen. Pass up the floor now. We'll go to Holmstrom, who cuts middle of the lane. And we'll give it right corner for Hayline. Hayline gets it out top to Reinen. Now McNary, a long three. Up and in! That was a deep three from out top. And McNary drops it in good. And it's now a 21-point Roncalli lead as they have dominated to start out this third quarter. And another timeout called by Sisseton. Down to Ethan Cranhold out front. Roncalli in man-on-man defense have played it most of the second half, and it's kind of frustrated the Redmen. Out front, Everson in the game, tries to go for a steal, doesn't get it. It will be Fitz dropping it off to White on the wing. Now they'll give it off to Cranhold, who will drive to the paint, and he's going to be fouled in. Maidenwald will inbound left, and the ball is going to be knocked away by Reedy, and right back into the hands of Maiden to play there by Reedy to get the arms out and take away the passing lane. Back the other way comes Roncalli. Right side, McNary with it. Will spin to the basket. Loses control. Now in midair. Puts it up. Kind of lost control of the ball. And misses the shot long. Rebound will kick out to Maidenwald. He'll bring it the other way as Roncalli will drop back into half-court man defense. Left side is Fitz. Works it low block to White. His shot up and over. Schaefauer is up and in. White's first points of the second half. Sisseton's first points. That stops the 14-0 run. And the Cavs now back the other way offensively. Holmstrom with the ball. Top of the key. They'll work it down low on the block. McNary dribbles it off his foot, but will save it. And now we'll get it out front to Reedy. Left side, Holmstrom from three, up and in. Daniel Holmstrom hits his second three of the night. Third three of this third quarter for Roncalli. 51-29 Cavs. 2:40 to play third period. Cranhold across the timeline. We'll give it right side. Here's a good look for three, but it's blocked by Daniel Holmstrom. Mosier had a wide open look for three, but took a long time, and it allowed Holmstrom to time to get there and block it away. Now Holmstrom taking a little break here. 2:27 to play in the quarter. Schaefauer inbounds under the basket. Gets it out front for Holmstrom. He'll dump it down low, and tough shot from underneath for Zach Hemrick, but he comes back through with kind of a little curl and puts it up and in. Hemrick has 14, 53-29 Cavs. Cranhold the other way. We'll give it right wing for Nealand on the wing now. Sisseton will give it off to Mosier. Now the pass left out front for Nealand. Has trouble with it. We'll get the ball back. We'll get it down low to Mosier. Now off to Maidenwald on the wing. He'll get it out top. White thought about a three briefly. We'll give it back off to Maidenwald now. Maidenwald to White, who brings it into the paint. Puts up a shot. Tough with two guys on him and puts it high off the glass. No good. Rebound by the Cavaliers. Holmstrom will get it right wing to Reedy. He'll dribble along the arc. And now we'll penetrate. Dishes off to Schaefauer in the corner. Schaefauer back to Reedy on the left wing. Now to Hemrick. Double teamed in the lane. He'll turn. Puts it up over three black shirts and puts it up and in. At 6'8", Zach Hemrick, just a tough guard for Sisseton. They have nobody to match up with him size-wise. And Hemrick really taking advantage. 16 now in the ballgame. Maidenwald with the basketball. Will take it in. Throws up an off-balance runner. Hoping for a whistle. Didn't get it. Rebound cleared by Everson. He'll get it up the floor to Schaefauer. He'll take it up in traffic. Shot swatted away, but picked back up by Reedy, and Reedy's going to draw a blocking foul from Nealand. Sam Reinen in. Jaden Everson will inbound from the right corner for the Cavs. They'll inbound it. Reedy's three on the way. No good, but he's going to be fouled by Maidenwald, and that'll put trying to build the lead to 29. Free throw up and good for Gus Reedy. Second shot for Reedy is up and good. Into the game for Sisseton. Get the ball back for the third. And that one is up and good. Just like a made three there for Gus Reedy. Knocks them all down. 58-29. Cavaliers have owned this third quarter, and that's an understatement. Across the timeline, Nigg picks up the dribble. We'll get it to White. He'll look at the three. Now gets it in the corner for Cranhold. Try to screen for him. Cranhold instead will take it baseline. Dumps it back off. Nigg will go out front to White. Didn't want it. Now dribbles down to the block and will try to float it over to Cranhold, but he's got to run it down out near the timeline. Shot clock down to 13. Cranhold trying to dribble. And now a reaching foul is going to get called on Jaden Everson. He exposed the ball, and Everson got a piece of it. Cranhold inbounding right of the basket. Will put it out front for Mosier. Now into the corner. Here's Cranhold from three. Missed everything. Rebound backside by Schaefauer. They'll get the ball to Everson. Now up the floor to Hemrick. In the paint, he'll go to Schaefauer, and he'll put it up and good. And Schaefauer will go to the free throw line with an and one. And the shot on the way for Schaefauer is up and no good. Cranhold, the rebound, will pull it down with 30 seconds to go. Cranhold up the right side. We'll get it in the corner for Mosier. Now Mosier will take it to the basket. His shot is up and partially blocked. No good. He wanted a whistle. Didn't get it. Cavs will hold for one here with Everson holding it out near the center circle with 12 seconds to play in the quarter. Out front, the Cavs try to set it up, but now they're going to come out and screen. Everson will drive and dish to Schaefauer into the corner from three. Up and good. Spencer Schaefauer. And that puts an exclamation point on a third quarter. Really tight ball game, I felt, at halftime. Ron Colley with the ball to start out the fourth quarter. McNary will dump it off to Sam Ryan. 15-footer left corner up and no good. And the rebound grabbed by the Redmen. But, boy, the damage done in that third period. Cavaliers 10 of 14 shooting from the floor. Sisseton just 1 of 10. Here is Maidenwald with a shot from the free throw line extended. He'll hit it short but get it to crawl in. Just the fourth point of the second half for the Redmen. Cavaliers back the other way. Landon Hayline out on the perimeter. Uses up the dribble. Now we'll get it to Hemrick, middle of the lane. Hemrick will work it down low to McNary underneath. Top reverse layup up and good. Braden McNary kind of created that on his own from underneath the basket. Tough shot, but he gets it to go. McNary with 15. Hunter Maidenwald will go left side to Andrew Fitz. Now top of the key, White will leave it off to Nealand. Nealand at the free throw line extended, brings it back foul line. Now we'll take it in. Puts up the runner. Can't get it to go. And coming back in from out of bounds. Up the middle of the floor, Holmstrom with the basketball. Sisseton staying man-on-man defensively. Holmstrom will get it to Hemrick. Now out front is Hayline. He'll put up the 14-footer in the paint. Shot won't go. Rebound by Hemrick. Ball is knocked away, but McNary will get it back. Now they'll find Holmstrom cutting backside. Great feed by McNary, and he puts it up and good. 67-31 Cavs as Sisseton brings it back across the timeline. Maidenwald will dribble off to the right side, goes top of the key to Nealand. He'll launch a 17-footer. Shot no good. Rebound tapped by Holmstrom, but then Hayline goes down to the ground to save it. Long pass up the floor, now thrown away. Just the second turnover of the game for Ron Colley, picked off by Ethan Cranhold. Cranhold double-teamed left corner. Will get it out front to Nealand. Now into the right corner. Good look for three, and again Holmstrom comes through, and it will remain Sisseton basketball. Maidenwald will inbound from the right corner and will lob it out top, and the ball again tipped away by Holmstrom. It'll go out of bounds, and Ethan Cranhold. Cranhold will give it right side to Fitz on the perimeter. Now free throw line, Dominic White with it. White will go left side to Cranhold. Tries to direct traffic. Cranhold will pull down, pulls up a 15-footer left baseline, shot up and long, no good. Rebound pulled down by Hemrick. They'll get it into the hands of McNary up the right side of the floor. McNary cuts into the paint, dumps it off. Holmstrom will drive, dishes back to McNary. A long three, up and good. McNary again feeling it. His fourth three here tonight. He's got 18 in the ballgame. 70-31. Cavaliers have had an unbelievable second half. Left side with it. Andrew Fitz dribbling along the arc. Will give it right side to Hunter Maidenwald. Maidenwald goes into the corner for Mosier. And now out front, here's a... Sisseton will inbound from underneath and lobbing it out front. Maidenwald will get it into the hands of Andrew Fitz. Fitz will give it to Mosier. He'll knock down a 12-footer from the right wing. That's Mosier's first basket of the night. 70-33. Back the other way now. Reinen will give it to Hayline. Now into the paint for Holmstrom. Nice reverse drive from underneath. Reverse layups up and good on the baseline drive. Off the pass from Zach Hemrick. And the Cavaliers continue to roll here. 4 of 5 shooting in this fourth quarter after 10 of 14 in that third period. 72-33. Cavs continue to pull away. Out front, Cranhold dribbling along the top of the key. Will give it right side to Dustin Mosier, and Mosier will knock it down good. Mosier's hit his last two shots down the floor. And that'll cut the lead in half here, 72-36 the score. With the ball right side is Hayline, had it in front of the Ron Colley bench. Pass will come to Hemrick at the free throw line. It'll get dumped back to him from Holmstrom, and then it'll be an inbound pass from Holmstrom to a wide open Zach Hemrick, who lays it up and in from underneath the basket. Hemrick with 18 now tonight. And with 4:17 to go, the Cavaliers continue to roll here. Out front, Ethan Cranhold will give it top of the key. There's a three up and way short by Mosier. It will go out of bounds, and it will be, shot won't go. Rebound pulled down by Holmstrom, double teamed as he brings it in, and now he'll pass out of it, getting it to McNary near the timeline. McNary across the stripe will dump it down right wing, will give it to Hemrick in the corner, underneath to Hayline. His shot, point blank range, up and in and out, no good. The Redmen back the other way, and now Todd Neundorf's going to clear out his bench here as 3.5 minutes to go. Nathan Nigg will drive and will leave it off on the perimeter for Mosier. Mosier comes back out front to Maidenwald, who goes to Nigg right wing. Nigg now to Cranhold, 15-footer, up and off the back iron, no good. Rebound by Hemrick, and the Cavs will put it in McNary's hands. McNary across the timeline will cross over, and now will put up a little runner from eight and knock it down good. And McNary now will have his fifth straight game of 20 points as he will put it up and in, and it'll be a complete.
Freshly deviled eggs and more. 16-ounce monster drinks, $1.79 in the travel center. They also carry Fenix Roadmaster and Wintermaster premium diesel fuel. The Airport Cafe and Travel Center across from the airport.
Now on Jaden Everson and Nealand here at the foul line. First free throw is up and good. Neal lead with 3 minutes to go, as it has been all Ron Colley this second half. Second free throw up and off the mark, no good. Logan Karst, the rebound in for Ron Colley. Karst, Sam Van Orman, Gus Reedy into the ball game. He'll get the ball left corner from three. Perfect. Gus Reedy's first three of the night, and 8 points off the bench. Everson and Schaefauer also in the ball game here for Ron Colley. Across the timeline is Maidenwald. He'll drive to the basket. Got too deep. Forces up a shot and way over the mark. No good. Karst the backside with the ball. We'll pull it in. We'll go to Schaefauer. Down low. Reedy on the block. Had a little trouble with the pass. We'll get it back. Puts it off the glass too hard and can't get it to go. Rebound pulled down by the Redmen with 2:25 to play. Across the line, Cranhold will take it into the paint and will put up the 12-foot runner and gets it good. And now a timeout or stoppage of play here for 79-39. Cavaliers with the lead. Sam Van Orman with the basketball. We'll give it to Everson. Now right corner, Logan Karst. Karst out front. Reedy launches from three. Shot off the mark, no good. Rebound pulled down by Ethan Cranhold. That was Austin Steichen for Sisseton. Steichen will give it off to Fitz. Now on the wing for Logan Shoneman. Shoneman gets it out top to DJ White. A three from the top of the key is up and no good. Rebound is pulled down by the Cavaliers into the hands of Reedy over on the left wing. Reedy leaves it off to Van Orman out front. Van Orman will get it to Logan Karst. He'll launch a three, and that one is long, no good. Rebound battled for out on the perimeter. Bodies on the deck, and finally a jump ball called as Karst bring it up across the timeline. Fitz goes right side to Gill on the wing. Now to DJ White at the top of the key. White will go left for Fitz, who brings it foul line, gets it off. Here's a high arcing three from out front, no good by Dane Gill. And the rebound pulled down by Everson with 1:10 to play. Into Logan Karst's hands. Karst dribbles along the arc. We'll get it to Schaefauer. Now the long cross-court pass. Reedy will launch again from three and knocks it down good. Gus Reedy with his second three here in the fourth quarter. 11 in the ballgame. 82-39 the score. And across the timeline, Andrew Fitz with the basketball. Will dribble right. And we'll leave it off in the corner. Dribbling. Here's an off-balance shot up and no good by Austin Steichen from the right baseline. Rebound pulled down, I believe, by Schaefauer, and they'll give it off to Jaden Everson, who brings it across the timeline with 30 seconds to go. 26 on the shot clock. Cavaliers are just going to spread it out. Sisseton will come out and force the basketball. Now here's a long pass underneath. Reedy wide open down under the basket. Shot good. Sisseton just had nobody within 10 feet, and Reedy all alone under the basket. I don't think Sisseton thought that the Cavaliers are just going to run it out. Here's a runner by Andrew Fay. But boy, what a second half here for Aberdeen. Ron Colley, and what a third quarter to break this one open. Andrew Fitz will put it out top into the hands of Dane Gill. Three-point shot, no good. Cavaliers a rebound. It's been fun to watch you come along this year. Congratulations. I know there's a long way to go yet, too. But, yeah. A nice night here tonight. 18 points, and how'd it feel out there? I mean, it was tough to get you going, but once you got going, you really seemed to take off.
Yeah, once we got started, we got into our motion, and we started getting open looks. We didn't settle for one, and we passed it around, and we hit the open man, and we got easy baskets.
Well, and I know that Coach wants you to get involved more, but I know you want to do it in the flow of the offense. Is that what kind of happened here tonight?
Yeah. They got me the ball, and then I felt where he was, and I managed to get something going and helped us get the lead and the win.
Well, and, you know, I got to say, too, offensively, you know, those are the stats that jump out. But on the defensive end, you've done a lot of stuff. You cover a lot of ground down there. And, you know, for a big guy, you're in shape. And I know you like to run.
I wouldn't say I like to run. I just can. I mean, running is running, and you have to do it in these kinds of sports.
Yeah, yeah. Well, and again, you cover a lot of ground covering that back end. Do you take some pride in that?
I do. I enjoy playing defense a lot more than offense, actually. And I appreciate my teammates who help me out in times, too.
Well, and I know it's a lot of fun, and tonight they just didn't have a matchup for you. Could you feel that as the game went on?
Yeah, as the game kept going on, I couldn't understand how it was going, and I managed to get the shots that I needed to make.
You bet. Well, I know a big one coming up Saturday. You'll prepare tomorrow, but Sioux Valley, a team with some bigs in there, so it should be a fun matchup for you.
Yes, it should.
Congratulations on a great game. Best of luck here Saturday, too, Zach.
Yeah, thank you.
Thanks. Cavalier head coach Todd Neundorf joins us. And, Coach, what a difference from first half to the second half. It felt really tight at halftime. They hung around. Was it just the man defense you switched to that changed things, or what happened?
Well, yeah, that happened. We switched. You know, and we got after them a little bit at halftime just because we gave up 27 first half points. And, you know, really need to – we challenged the guys at halftime, said we are not giving up 40. And that was our goal. And you can ask every kid in there. We said we're not giving up 40. So that's why they were up jumping around, because it was at 39, and I just challenged them, because, you know, we were on our way to giving up 54 points, and it turned into an NBA game in the first half where they'd score, we'd score, they'd score, and it was just like who could take it out of bounds quickest so we can get down the other end. And, you know, that's not the way we play. You know, we got out of our full court stuff because, you know, it was non-effective, and we, our man-to-man defense is, you know, that's what sparks everything. That's what gets the crowd in it. That's what gets players in it. When you get a stop and you put consecutive stops together and you can get out and run, you know, you put two stops together, that could be 6 points. So then that lead goes from 7 automatically to 13. And the way we were doing it in the first half was they hit a 3 and we'd hit a 3. They hit a 2, and that's not the way we need to play. And we challenged them pretty big at halftime, and we got after them, and they responded. So real credit to the kids. And we told them that's a level that they have to play at. I don't know if we can play better than that, that second half. I mean, if we could bottle that second half, I don't know if I can get them to play any better than that. Because that's as good as we can play. That's as good as any. And if you play that way, you feel pretty good about how your chances are.
Well, you do. And I know, again, we talked a little earlier in the week that you were wanting to get more man-on-man defense out there. I was kind of surprised because I thought, well, you're keeping that pressure to wear them down a little bit. But I think the man-on-man did that better.
Yeah, it did. And we just thought we were, you know, they had a pretty good scheme of things, how they wanted to break it, and it was a long stretch for us to cover the way they were breaking it. So that's okay. You know, we'll just as you get later in the year, you know, that stuff, you know, you got to use it sparingly, because as you run into teams and it's out there and people see it and they come up with different ways of breaking it, you got to rely on the basics. And when it comes down to it, it's about getting stops and getting easy baskets on the other end. And, you know, I can't say enough about Hammer and Braden and Daniel and holy cow, Sam Reinen. You know, we talked the other night about Sam, and Sam had a tough night, but boy, did he step up tonight. He had 14, it looks like. And, you know, it was Landon's night to be, you know, a little down and out. But that's the thing about this group. There's always somebody else that that pulls the weight up. And so it's a really good effort, and we're excited going into Saturday.
Yeah, Saturday will be a tough matchup. I mean, you look at Sioux Valley's record. I think they've lost 5 times this year, but that's a really good team you're going to be up against.
Well, and they've lost 5 times, and they haven't lost any weak sisters either. Mm-hmm. You know, they play a really good schedule, and, you know, they lost to Clarkville Lake, who's a very good basketball team, and that was the first game of the year. And then, you know, the Vincent kid's been dinged up.
Right.
And I don't know if he'll be back or not, but, you know, when they get all, Coach Vincent will have his crew ready to go, and they haven't played since the 20th, so you know, they've been preparing for us, and we get one day tomorrow to kind of get ready. So it'll be a good challenge, and it'll be a fun one in the Corn Palace.
Yeah, sure will. And we'll have that one. 5:30 Saturday is the start time from the Hanson Classic. But, boy, again, second half, you're absolutely right. And I did want to point out, I don't know what you have for your numbers. Two turnovers tonight. Is that close to accurate?
I haven't looked, but okay. I can honestly say I've never coached a team that's had two turnovers.
No. I've never seen that. So impressive in that second half. I agree. If you can play better than that, that's going to be really something to watch.
I remember the turnovers. I mean, Daniel had one, a pick six mm-hmm. down here, and one was in the first half.
A steal and a return the other way. Yep. The block.
Yeah.
Was it the block?
It was a block.
Yeah.
So I remember the two turnovers.
Mm-hmm.
So, I don't know.
Yeah. Yep.
We're going to call it that. We're going with your stats.
All right. Sounds like a plan. Well, Coach, again, congratulations. Good luck tomorrow getting ready, and we'll see you Saturday.
All right. Thanks, Scott.
Thanks, Todd. Todd Neuendorf, head coach of the Cavaliers. And again, Ron Colley wins it here tonight by a final score of 84-39. Again, outscoring Sisseton by a 50-12 margin, 50-12 in that second half of play. The JV game won tonight by Ron Colley. So, again, a nice night for the Cavs. And again, our congratulations to them. We'll have their game from the Hanson Classic coming up on Saturday versus Sioux Valley. The Cossacks, one of the teams figured in the upper echelon this year. And again, they've battled through some injuries. They've gone on a little win streak, so it should be a fun ball game. 5:30, the scheduled tip time from the Hanson Classic. Full day of games down at the Corn Palace. We'll be on the air with it, and we'll start our pregame show out probably around 5:15 or so on Saturday evening. Again, our thanks to you for listening. Scott back at the station. Thanks to you, Brian Lundquist, the videographer here tonight, and of course to all of you for watching and listening, and most importantly, our sponsors for making the broadcast possible. Again, your final score tonight, 84-39, Ron Colley over Sisseton. We'll be back with more Cavalier basketball on Saturday right here on Pheasant Country 103. You've been listening.